Well, this is Winter, a 2D game development framework for Faro. This is a personal project, but it's also my final project at the university. This is me. I'm Álvaro Piorno. I'm student at National University of Quilmes and Smalltalk developer at Markup. I will be talking about which was my motivation, looking for a solution, from Dead Storm to Living Winter, obviously a demo, and future work. Well, what was my motivation? I will give an initial context of how is the game industry today. It has grown a lot since last year. It has grown from focus market to mainstream. Improvements in technology has contribute to enhancement of video game experience. Obviously, technology industry and game industry grows like together, because if technology advances, obviously games advance too. Game industry excels because it anticipates demand, giving people what they want before they realize they want it, because of the previous step I described. It employs traditional developers, but also needs people tailored to the game industry. Some of those specific disciplines are game programmer, game designer, level designer, and a lot of game component plus designer. Our job here, if we want to be a game developer, would be the game programmer. And as our main tool, we should use game frameworks or game engines. So, game frameworks and game engines. Are they same? Are they different? Lot of people don't know the difference. They always say game engines as a generic word, because they call the software like something that make games, and they don't know the real difference. So I will make some points to show you the difference. This. Game frameworks are purely programmatically, so they do not assist the user. Game engines are supposed to do more than game frameworks and assist a lot the user. Game frameworks are often libraries exposed with a unified API. Game engines are libraries, sub-engines composed of more libraries, and they have graphic tools supporting the user every time. You can build an engine from a framework if you develop a lot and give the framework graphic tools and assistant tools and all that stuff. But you obviously cannot make a framework from a game engine. It would be the same from destroying a house to get a brick. Game frameworks are like the skeleton that determines the architecture and program flow of a game, and the game engines are the muscles that do all the work. All. First of all, I want to say one or no, two or three semesters ago, I had a subject at the university named Introduction to Video Game Development, and I obviously wanted to use something made with Smalltalk to develop a game with Smalltalk. And I started a quick search, like a normal user in Google. But I made a generic search to view all the possibilities. So, Unity, the most popular game engine. As you can see, you have a graphic environment assisting all, you do all by clicking and searching menus, buttons. You can see what the elements on the scene and the language supported are C#, Vue, I don't know that language, and JavaScript. This is the most popular, not only because it's a game engine and it's very easy to use, but because even a non-programmer can develop games using this because of the assistance and the because of the language that supports. This one is a complicated example of a game engine. As a game engine, it assists a lot the user, but as it supports the language is C++, obviously a non-programmer cannot use this. Or you will have games with a lot of memory leaks. These two are game frameworks. Obviously, they don't have graphic tools, so I have nothing to show you. But the logos, libgdx supports Java and all languages that uses the Java Virtual Machine, and Pygame that supports Python. And when I reached the moment to look for something in Smalltalk, I get this. Well, at this point, the problem was I wanted to use something to develop games on Smalltalk, and I didn't have nothing to use. So the problem, this is the problem because it happened to me, so it can happen to anyone else. So to this problem, I wanted to look for a solution. So where to start? I didn't have any experience with that kind of software. I'm not studying an engineering, so I don't have strong basis on math. And the only thing I have related to games were two or three games developed using libgdx with Java. So I was like with nothing. So I started investigating and looking for something to learn about this. So I found this book, Game Engine Architecture from Jason Gregory. It's a very big book. And as all books related to this, it starts obviously with math. And as I didn't want to read the whole book to start developing something, I started making some basic model and tests, obviously with math. And something was strange. I was developing all math from scratch, points, vectors, transformations, and there was something strange. I should not develop that kind of software from scratch. Surely something made something before. So I asked myself, am I rewriting the will? A point class also was there in Faro, a rectangle also, and all the methods to for transformations and that all what I was doing from scratch in vain. So I started a new search, more advanced this time. At this point, I realized what Isaac was, so my search was a bit more better. So was something done about this? Something like libraries complete or incomplete, game frameworks complete or incomplete. The same with game engine. Something just to not do it all again. So, and with some help of friends, I came into Storm and Woden 2. Storm was a small 2D game development framework with foreign function integration with Chipman 2D, that is a physics library made on C. It was developed by Esteban Lorenzano. It was made in Faro 2 or 3, I think. It uses Ascent Skyro for graphics, Native Boost for foreign function integration, two call functions from this library. Woden 2 is a game engine developed by Ronnie Salgado. It was developed on Faro. It uses a local VM, that is a modified VM by himself. And uses two native libraries that are Abstract GPU and Abstract Physics, that are low-level abstraction layers for graphics and simulations of physics. So I have these two options to take and try to do something. And this is a comparison. Storm is 2D, Woden is 3D. Storm was a prototype. It's obviously an incomplete project, and it was made by Lorenzano to play and make some living code on configurations. And it was simpler to me, and Woden 2 obviously was more complex, including the setup for this. As it's a complete project, I have nothing to do here, but I had a lot of work to do with Storm. So I selected Storm to start to make it grow up. So, the next point, from Death Storm to Living Winter. Why Death Storm? I contacted Esteban Lorenzano, and the first phrase he said to me was, Storm died a long time ago. But while I contacted him, and he helped me a lot, to try to make Storm rise again. So, Storm, as I mentioned some slides ago, was developed on Faro 203. It uses Anselm Cairo, native boost from Fourier function integration, and Chikman 2D version 6 for physics. And this is how winter should look like when it rises again. It should use Faro 6 with a 64 bits VM, Athens Cairo. It's truly updated, but I didn't have any problem with Athens Cairo. Native Boost was removed, and Esteban Lorenzano developed this new framework named Unified Fourier Function Integration that replaced Native Boost. And Chikman also updated, so Winter must use the 7 version of Chikman. Well, problems I had trying to do this and solutions. Problems. Some Chikman functions didn't do what they should do in 64 bits VM. I had a lot of VM crashes on 32 bits VM on Linux at least, and I couldn't try on Windows because builds fails always. Well, for the solutions, I obviously this is a project for the university and not only a personal project. I made some choices I didn't like, but I didn't have the time to make better choices, so I had to leave Chikman aside and try to simulate physics on Smalltalk and start adding the new features I wanted to add to Winter. These are the new features, and the state. Sound of music, it's done. It's done, but sound doesn't work on Faro, on Linux distribution, so the feature is done, but on Linux it doesn't sound because it doesn't work on Faro. Well, sprites, user inputs management to move your player, asset management to manage globally all over the game, tiles and tile maps are in progress, and those are in to-do progress, to-do state, I mean, demo. This is our... This is a...
Carajo.
This is a very well known game. You should know this game, but know nothing.
Let's play.
It's a bit slow because it simulates physics on Smalltalk, obviously. Well, dream blocks should disappear as you saw. Yellow blocks become green blocks and red blocks become yellow blocks. That's all the game.
You lost.
Future work. Obviously, the features that are on to the state, animations, camera, interactive feedback, particles effect, and I would like to go back to Chikman 2D or another physics library, and to add network API for LAN and online games. As I started from Storm and not from scratch, I can say that after the storm comes the winter, and prepare yourself, winter's coming. Thanks, and special thanks to Esteban Lorenzano for his help, and Julian Maestri for the design of the slides. Mine were horrible. That's all, questions? Questions?
Okay. How big is the framework? How many classes? How many? You know, do you have an idea?
How can I give?
All the course of classes. I'm sorry.
You want the number of classes?
Well, just give us a feeling of what do you think is it? A big framework, is it difficult, not so difficult to write it?
Well, I needed to learn a lot to know what Esteban Lorenzano did with Storm, and it's not that big, but it uses a lot of things and concepts I didn't know.
How long were you working?
This semester.
Okay.
Anyone else? Thanks.